Fernie, I have a 9-week-old GSD. When can I start using the e-collar on her? Please help.
Don't even think about it right now. 9-week-old German Shepherd. This is what I want you to do. Take the dog's daily food, put it into a bag. See, what you're trying to do is, the reason why you asked me that, because you want to stop stuff. Okay? It's you. You're the one that got the 9-week-old dog. Be prepared for a fucking shit show. No sleep. Lots of stress. Lots of frustration. So, massive amounts of structure. 20 hours a day in a crate. Not continuous. But at 9 weeks old, that's about how much time they should be in a crate. So, take their food. Take their food bag. Keep it on you. Do lots of sits, down, place, recall, kennel up, come out, waiting for food. Every time that dog approaches you, make sure it sits. Stop play biting. You can use a bonker on that. People are like, never, you never correct a dog that young. Yes, you can. Everything's on a schedule. Everything is the same. Introduce that dog to as many environmentals as possible. Don't pick it up other than to maybe do like simulated vet check stuff and sensory stuff. Don't carry the damn dog around though, because it's going to be a GSD. Start with that stuff. Next. Going live. Now we're live. Live. How's everybody doing? What's today? Happy Wednesday. Hey everybody, how are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Zoe is my co-host today, and Joelle is on vacation, and we're gonna have a special look at your fucking glasses. What's that from? That from it's gonna be your from your screen. And I'm gonna have a new co-host. We're doing a Friday show this week. We're also doing a Friday show. Can you just check your volume real quick?
Go.
Yep, there we go. Okay, we're doing a Friday show this week. But Zoe's actually going home back to Texas. Gave her a couple of days off to just go home, just to hang out with some family for a couple of days. She'll be back next week working, and then Joelle's comes back next week at some point. I'm not quite sure what day.
Sunday.
But so this is it. It's a Q&A show. So a little bit of a recap. What we do is this. It'll be a 90-minute show tonight. A lot of people, I want folks, if you've never seen the show before, to look at the flavor of the questions. It's always, how do I stop? How do I stop? How do I stop? How do I stop? So in order to stop a behavior, an unwanted behavior in dog training, you've got to apply a punisher. If you want to call it a correction, call it a correction, but you have to apply a negative something. Now, we just did a Facebook Live today that shows you how we train place. It's all reward-based, tons of reward-based stuff. So you can do that. Sound quality sucks. I know, guys, on that one. All right. So what you'll do is, most people ask about how to stop things. You can hear me use the word punishment a lot. Most answers need a very complete answer. Most of my conversations, I need to talk to people longer. But you'd be surprised how many people get stuff fixed from this. Also, I've got YouTube videos. You can watch my YouTube videos. I've got such a big body of content. Follow us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, attend all of our Q&As, ask questions, start putting together everything. Also, a lot of the questions I answer for other people also can be applied to you. Remember that. I do a seminar series called Jeff Gellman Seminars. I do 25 dates out of the year. Approximately 1,000 people attend those a year. My next one is going to be in Anchorage, Alaska. I've never been to Alaska before. I'm looking forward to that one. That's going to be a fantastic seminar. Go to Jeff Gellman Seminars to look at that. Now, those are also problem-solving seminars. So people come to my seminars to stop dog aggression, human aggression, leash reactivity, separation anxiety, slowness of commands. So we specialize in stopping unwanted stuff, but obviously we have to train the dogs to do what we want as well. And then we do a boarding train at the training center here in Providence, as well as we do puppy class, and we also do one-on-one. So there's a little dollar sign down at the bottom, right underneath where it says say something. It'll say your name, then say something, the little dollar sign. A lot of people like to throw us a little bit of spending money. Number one, they appreciate the 15 years of content that we've produced that's transformed their dogs. A lot of people's lives have been transformed. And your question does get queued up to the top. But you do not have to pay to play. We will get through. Well, we try to get get through every single question that you ask. Here we go.
Britt, what do you do when teenager and kids see my shepherd not wanting them to come near them, but they are still trying to interact, stretching my shepherd out during training can be irritating. Thanks.
So what I want you to do is this. So I'm very, very nice about it. If somebody asks me, I say, thank you for asking, but no, you can't pet my dog. If somebody now breaks that barrier, now you can be rude. You can do anything you want. Push them out of the way. Yell at them. No, back off. Don't touch my dog. Hands off. Back off. Push them out of the way. It's all about boundary issues. A lot of folks have a hard time saying no. The reason is because we don't want to hurt someone's feelings. When someone says, oh, I don't have a hard time saying no, I like to flip it. Most of our clients, 70% of our clients are female. I've got 6 daughters. I'm surrounded by female. So we do a lot of female empowerment stuff. And the bottom line is this, ladies, you do have boundaries. You know you have boundaries, right? If somebody came up to you and just grabbed your boobs, I don't think you would say, stop that, right? Knee to the nuts, fucking head to the knee, right? Got it? Kick them in the balls, break their nose, push them back. Correct? Everybody should learn that move. Now, do you do that with someone that tries to pet your dog? No, but you do have boundaries. You do have boundaries. Put the don't pet my dog into that boundary. Next.
Julie, is it common for a dog to still pull a little on her leash with the prong collar on? Our dog still gets alerted to sound and smells for the first 10 minutes of our walk until she calms down.
Okay, so you're doing it wrong. So that's handler error. Guys, a prong collar is a communication tool that doesn't train. Training trains. A clicker doesn't train. Training trains. Food doesn't train, training trains. You still have to train the dog. So what are you doing actively? Or are you just letting the dog decide? So right from the beginning, watch my healing video. Don't let the dog sniff. You have more control over the dog than you think. So this concept of putting a collar on a dog and it's just going to listen, pushing a button and it's going to listen, it doesn't work that way. You still have to do training. Next.
Ari, 6-month-old, working GSD, tips for getting confidence around people. He's allowed pats from strangers for 2 more weeks only. He will be a police service dog.
Okay, so you're going to get a dog that like goes out in the community. Well, if it's going to be a police service dog, which is usually a dog that goes out into the community, it's schools and things like that. If we heard that right, believe it or not, you can socialize him for a lot longer than that. So as far as confidence building, you definitely want a good, confident dog. If not, the dog has to be washed. So what I would do is get the dog exposed to as many environmentals, Ari, as you can. As many environmentals as you can. Work on all your obedience commands. Hold the dog accountable. Get the dog to experience. So environmentals being sound and especially vibration, trucks going by, different, dry grass, wet grass, cement, dirt, sand, slippery floors, as many things as you can. Next.
Scattered Storm. Hi, guys.
Hey, Scattered Storm.
Julie, we only have been using it a few weeks.
Okay, that's about the day. But you can do this from day one. You're using it wrong. Literally on day one, you can have a great walk. So don't keep waiting. Watch my video on how to properly walk the dog. So you put the collar on the dog. At the doorway, you pop your dog into a proper sit, and then you go for a walk. The dog is not allowed to sniff on the walks. It's dog training. So watch my videos. I'm not mad. I'm not upset. I don't shame owners, but I want people to know that you actually have to control the conversation. Next.
Bitless Equestrian, so excited for tonight's show.
Oh, me too. I'm excited for every single show.
Aldo, Zoe, you're doing great on Instagram vid. Thank you.
Yeah, we're really proud of her.
Julie, nice. Where in Texas? Zoe, San Antonio.
San Antonio, where all the good Texans come. Unless you're from Austin or Houston or... You ever been to Fredericksburg?
No.
I think it's called Fredericksburg.
Yeah, there's Fredericksburg.
Yeah, it's
Texas.
German immigrants founded that town. It's a fantastic town. We drive through there in our RV from when we go in Dallas heading out west. And we love it there. It's a great little tourist town. Next.
Kay, do you think having a formal education in dog training is important before starting a board and train? I have a moderate skill level and plan to start with basic obedience, leash reactivity, etc.
No. What do you mean by formal education? Like what? Your high school or college or dog training? Dog training certifications? I'm sorry. I have no certifications at all. So, and it's, people use that against me. It's like, oh my God, no. I've trained 7,000 dogs. If you want me to take a test tomorrow, I'll take a test tomorrow. Big deal. That's all it is. It's a memorization test. That doesn't tell you anything. It doesn't tell you anything. Guys, it's dog training. There's so many dog trainers out there that want to make it look like it's this complicated thing. It's dog training. It's yes and it's no. Now, there is a skill set on like rehabbing aggression, but getting a dog to sit and to down and to place and to walk on a leash, shut up in a crate, a lot of this stuff, your grandparents didn't use a dog trainer. Your parents most likely didn't use a dog trainer. Pet dog training is a new concept. And that's the thing about a lot of dog trainers. It's like they make us look like they want to be like held up to this status. And it's like, it's not that complicated, guys. Next.
Antonio, how do I stop my pup from running out of the cage like a bat out of hell? I watched your video about opening and closing the door and calms down and waits and just hauls ass when I tell him okay. Hi, team, working. So just sending some love and good vibes.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Leash on the dog. So slam that door in the dog's face like the video shows. Release the dog. Pop him into a sit. Next.
Mackenzie Jordan. Hi, Jeff and Zoe.
Hey, Mackenzie. How are you?
Mike, Jeff, thank you. Your training saved Maddie's life yesterday. She was attacked by a swarm of bees and was running around.
Jeez!
Didn't know what to do. I instructed her to come and she immediately obeyed.
Wow.
Dang.
Damn. Fuck that. Bees can be the worst. That's scary as shit. Next.
Aldo, question on recall. Jeff, at what point do you stop giving treat?
Oh, well, so when the dog's on, we showed it today. When a dog is on, correction mode, there's no food left. So food training can go all the way up to the point of correction. Once you go to correction, food should be gone. Definitely gone. You can take it away earlier than that, though. You can also do variable rewarding. But remember, remote collar training or any obedience training, you're doing hundreds and hundreds of repetitions. Next.
Mackenzie, Zoe, how did you get into dog training? My own dog.
Explain. Yeah. Share your story.
My dog just never listened to me. I was having so much trouble. I'd fight with her all the time. My bed was being torn up. I was having so much trouble, and then I found
your bed was torn up.
Yeah, cause okay, so she
How did your bed get torn up by your dog?
No, it was by me, cause I was trying to get her. Cause on my bed underneath.
You tore
it
up your bed
because
with like a knife and shit.
No. Like I would throw my bed off because I couldn't get her out from underneath my bed. Cause I would try to get her to go in the crate when I was leaving. So I'd have to go get her. So I'd have to like rip my bed apart to go get her from underneath my bed. And I was just tired of having to like get after her and like not listening. I was always late to things because of her. So then I found your videos and a bunch of other people's videos. And like I found my love for it. And then I emailed Jeff.
Yep.
And that was it.
Yep. That's it. Mm-hmm. And we took you out of Texas.
Yep.
Yep. We love having her here. Next.
Kay, hey Zoe, it's hotter than Hades here in Texas. Enjoy your time home. I know, I hear it's hot. I don't miss the Texas weather that much, at least as far as the hotness.
Next.
Mike, she ran to my feet and laid down, and I frantically was getting bees off of her. I got 39 stings, no idea about her, I'm
my
sure.
God! That's a lot of stings. Next.
Mary, why would a dog all of a sudden not want to stay on place and shake if you make him stay and wants break?
A lot of variables. I don't know. It could be distractions. It could be distractions that are around, a new level of distraction. It could be something spooked the dog, and now the dog is a little bit nervous about it. So what you'll do is, if your dog knows place, definitely, you've done a couple hundred times, now you apply your punisher. No, apply the punisher, which could be a leash pop, remote collar stim, lead the dog back. Next.
Becky, pup keeps putting front paws up on counter when I'm in the kitchen. Best way to stop this, e-collar?
Oh, yeah. E-collar and high. Next.
Tyler, hi. First time catching a live show. I have two dogs. My TWC will walk perfectly with the prong collar. My WPG still wants to pull ahead. What can I do?
Train the dog. So remember, guys, the collars aren't magical. So there's a 180 move you can do. Chances are what you're doing is you're allowing the dog to go too far in front of you. I cannot tell you how many times in my seminars that I just help people with leash handling and the timing of the pop, and the walk totally changes. Most people are waiting till the dog gets too far in front of them. Then they're applying the information, and then the dog, then it's not too late, but then you're always nagging the dog. Next.
Mike, without your training, she would have just run around and continued to get stung. Vet said she couldn't handle many more stings.
No shit. Dog could die. Damn. So, who's that, Mike?
Yes.
Mike, congratulations. I guess. I'm so glad that it didn't turn out any worse than it did. Next.
Donna, new Dutchie owner working with Prong Collar, very high prey drive with cats and other dogs. I started him tonight in our town with 45-minute walk. He starts to whine when overstimulated and locks on.
Yes. So if you own a Dutchie is not your average pet dog. In fact, I can almost go as far as saying a lot of pet owners shouldn't own a Dutch Shepherd. That doesn't make you a bad person. Don't get me wrong. I highly, highly suggest you find a skilled trainer that understands powerful, drivey dogs. Because a Dutchie is like, it's not quite a Malinois, but we're getting up there. So I would get that dog remote collar trained as quick as possible. I would make sure you've got massive amounts of structure. And you don't want to get rid of a dog's drive, but you want to be able to put an off switch into that dog ASAP. You can get that from watching a lot of our videos. Next.
Andrea, my pup sometimes likes to mount other dogs while at daycare. Is mounting showing dominance?
Mounting is just like... five trainers, five opinions. It's not always dominance. I call it an unacceptable behavior. If the daycare is telling you about this, they should know how to stop it. Like, you shouldn't have to tell them how to stop it. So if someone said, "Oh, by the way, what's his name?"
Andrea.
Andrea, by the way, your dog is humping dogs at daycare. Andrea, you should be like, "Well, stop it." Like, that is their job. Next.
Jared, hi Jeff and Zoe. Jeff, have you ever had any interest in wolves and studying their behaviors in relation to dogs' behaviors?
I have not. Next. That doesn't mean I won't. Okay. Interest in wolves? Yes. Studying their behaviors? No. Next.
9.99 top chat.
Ooh, look at that.
Diana
coming through with a 9.99.
I love you, Jeff, and your staff. Love you. Love all you do. Thank you for being an inspiration.
Okay, I love my staff. I've got an awesome staff. Just did a new hire. Has Nicole been in any photos yet?
No. No, she hasn't. So I told you to go back there and take a video of her today.
What was she doing?
Working dogs.
Was she?
Yeah, good I told for her. You. That's
how'd she do?
She did good. She's doing good.
Did she really? Cool. Proud of her. Well, you'll meet her on Friday.
Yeah, Friday.
I asked her in passing today.
No, I didn't.
I was leaving out there. We mentioned something about the show. She was standing there, and I'm like, "Do you want to do the show?" Like, before I finished the word "show," she's like, "Yes." So next.
Lynn, morning. I used Bonker on my GSD as he was trying to rush past me to go for a walk. Broke sit position. It shocked him. He ran back in room. When called him to me, he came out crawling along floor.
Okay, so make sure you say no, you bonk. Obviously, we don't want to see our dog crawling on the floor. It's okay, though, that it happens the first time. The dog's probably like, "Oh, shit, what did I do wrong?" I'm like, "Well, you ran past me. You could get hit by a car." So don't worry about it. Like, tomorrow's another day. Next.
Melissa says, evening, Jeff and Zoe. Evening,
hey,
Melissa.
Hey, Melissa. How are you? Love you, hon.
Fernie, I have a 9-week-old GSD. When can I start using the e-collar on her? Please help.
Don't even think about it right now. 9-week-old German Shepherd. This is what I want you to do. Take the dog's daily food, put it into a bag. So what you're trying to do is, the reason why you asked me that, because you want to stop stuff. Okay? It's you. You're the one that got the 9-week-old dog. Be prepared for a fucking shit show. No sleep, lots of stress, lots of frustration. So, massive amounts of structure. 20 hours a day in a crate, not continuous. But at 9 weeks old, that's about how much time they should be in a crate. So, take their food, take their food bag, keep it on you. Do lots of sits, down, place, recall, kennel up, come out, waiting for food. Every time that dog approaches you, make sure it sits. Stop play biting. You can use a bonker on that. People are like, never correct a dog that young. Yes, you can. Everything's on a schedule. Everything is the same. Introduce that dog to as many environmentals as possible. Don't pick it up other than to maybe do like simulated vet check stuff and sensory stuff. Don't carry the damn dog around though, because it's going to be a GSD. Start with that stuff. Next.
Dog on prong continues to stare at other dog after correction. Do you continue leash pop, correcting, or hold leash tight until dog focuses on you?
Don't hold the leash tight, because the opposition reflex will kick in. If anything, you can send that dog into drive. So for that, we use a remote collar. You can also do a gentle heel tap around the back. You can do that. But a remote collar nick usually will stop all that. Next.
Bitless equestrian. I hate that every time I'm out in public with my dog, most of the time I let people pet him. The next thing I know, they're out on their hands and he's making out with him. What's wrong with people?
Okay. Bitless equestrian. Let me flip this on you. It's called 100% responsibility. Own it. Stop letting people pet your dog. Don't you dare complain about it. Own it. Why don't I let people pet my dogs? Because of just like the way you described. And I've got very social dogs. So the big question is, why do you want people to pet your dog? That's a good question for everybody to ask. A lot of us are like, well, I want to show everybody how friendly they are. Why? What do you care? Why do you care what other people think? I don't care if people think my dogs are friendly or not friendly. Well, I'm looking to get laid, and I want all the pretty girls and even the half-pretty girls. And hell, some nights I'll take any girl to just pet my damn dog. You know, that's not me personally, okay? What I'm saying is, why do you want people to pet your dog? Next.
999 Top Chat. Dino.
Hey,
son
Dino.
And dog have been doing great treat protocol from your videos for a week. Also walking next to each other,
nice.
Taking it slow. Have seen great results since our Skype and listening to your videos for 4 months. Thank
awesome.
You.
Awesome. So proud of you. So proud of you. Next.
John, is there any specific reason why my pit Seth Mastiff would not like my sister? I know it's a vague question, but...
It's a very vague question.
But would e-collar correct this, or is it just a smell or something?
No, it's not a smell... Are we done?
Love everything you do.
Oh, thanks. No, I would need way more information. I would need so much information. I have no idea. I have no idea why. I have no idea why. Next.
Angelica. Hey, Jeff and Zoe. How soon is your availability for a Skype call?
Skype calls, I do every day. You know, 2 to 3 of them. Sometimes 4 of them, which is too many, frankly. Jessica, don't schedule me 4. I actually have to run this company. If you let's see, today is what day of the week is today?
Wednesday.
If you went onto our website, Sally Canine Training, and purchased a Skype, we would do a Skype next week. Next.
Bitless equestrian. At this point, I'm going to try to tell everyone not to pet him. It's dangerous with a dog you just met. You don't do that.
I know. You have to dummy proof your dog. And you have to be okay, you have to be okay telling people they can't pet your dog. But something about that is keeping you from doing that. So just think about that. Next.
Michelle, good evening, Jeff and Zoe. Good evening.
Hey, Michelle. Is that Michelle Anderson?
Yes.
Number one commenter on our YouTube channel.
G, hi, after proper training, can reactive...
Go ahead, sorry.
Can reactive dogs ever become social with other dogs? I've been trying...
God, yeah.
...my Yorkie's confidence, and it's helping, but we got a long way to go.
Yeah. I don't know your skill set. So, yes, they can. That's what we do here all the time. So, for instance, if you see, depends on what you mean by get along, and also there's a lot of variables, but you can take a, because reactivity is not aggression. Reactivity can be shut down instantly. So, but you can even take an aggressive dog and get it to acclimate with other dogs. But there's variables, the other dogs, your skill set, the humans in the room, there's a lot of different variables to it. That's it. Next.
Ari, to clarify, he's quite timid around men, only had female handlers want to bring him out
with
confidence and not increase fear.
Yeah, so that's the thing, Ari, is a lot of our clients, they're female dominated. So in most of my seminars are female dominated. A lot of people think that, oh, a man must have abused the dog. It's like, no, just lack of socialization. So Ari, go out there and meet some, you know, go meet some dudes, you know? You know, if you've got male friends, or if you've got, you know, male some people, have men come up, have them come up. Let them stand in front of you, start a conversation, click, reward. I don't let other people feed my dog, but you can click and reward your dog yourself. Next.
Bitless equestrian, 1-year-old Great Pyrenees. for the dog that she lets pet people.
Okay. That didn't answer my question. I don't give a shit what the, I don't care what the breed of the dog is. We're trying to solve the tongue in the mouth, the dog kissing the dog problem here. Next.
Christina, how do I stop my dog from staring at another dog while on a walk? I've tried flicking the prong, but she won't snap out of it, and I end up having to pull her away.
So, number one, don't allow your dog to move towards that dog and get a better heel out of that. Try a couple of 180s. If you want to do some directionals, so say you're walking like this, all of a sudden your dog starts staring at another dog like this, like, hey, baby, what's going on? What I want you to do is make a quick 90-degree turn, pop. Your dog goes, what the Frank Sinatra was that? Well, hello, I'm here. We just need the dog to become more handler aware. Next.
Aldo, another question. My dog scared off motorcycle or car exhaust. Always try to flee when we walk around it. Aw, man. What would you do?
Well, what I do is I would go into an island where there was no motor vehicles. That's what I would do. Now, what are we going to do in this situation is this. Teach your dog how to properly walk by you. Make sure you've got a really good heel. Start introducing your dog to environmentals. Start a little bit away from the cars. Work your way in. Those backfires, though, were motorcycles. Man, we got motorcycles by us. They freaking startle the hell out of me. There's always going to be the startling, but then what's the rebound? The dog might be startled, but goes up. Okay, I'm back. Next.
Julie, thanks for the answer. Our son lives about 20 miles away from Houston. Way humid.
Nice.
Okay.
I'll be in Austin, too, so coming up. When am I going to be in Austin?
November,
thank you. Jeff Gellman Seminars.
$10 Chop Chat from Gabriella. Hi, Jeff. Come do a seminar in Brazil, please.
So I'm speaking with Raquel soon. Raquel's got to invite me. Raquel's got to sponsor me, and we'll see what happens. Next.
Big guns. So I've been training my dog on e-collar for now for about 2 weeks. You said in a video that you don't go over 10 when training. However, I have to use 15 when outside. Is that okay?
What? Who said? One more time. Sorry, I was checking. I got issues going on in a lot of other categories of my life right here.
So I've been training my dog on e-collar for about 2 weeks. You said in a video that you don't ever go over 10 when training. However, I have
No. I have never, ever, 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 ever said that. That's not me. I am not the trainer that's ever said that. Just for full clarification. I have never said that. I actually say the opposite. I say your working level is your dog's working level. So, next.
Doyle.
And hold on. Sorry. The reason why I was so specific about that, some trainers do, and I'm like, what are you, fucking nuts? How could you tell an owner to never go over 10? How about if a dog doesn't feel it till it's at 15? Feel it till it's at 20? That's inside. Outside with environmentals? No. So that's why I got so like, what the fuck are you talking about? I've never said that. Next.
El Doyle. Hi, Jeff. I'm a lurker, but I'm finally participating. Our dog that has lived with cats for years killed our kitten out of nowhere last night. I need to fix this. What do you recommend me doing?
Ooh. I'd spay and neuter your cats, first of all. That's not necessarily, I hate to say that's not aggression. Cats are good food sources. They fucking taste good. This is the thing. What we do is we put dogs into avoidance around cats, meaning you don't even look at the cat. But there's some variables there. Next.
Justin, does my dog need tons of repetitions getting his herms finger popped around people to get him to not get hyper around strangers? Anything I can do inside the house?
Yeah, learn how to bonk the dog. Learn how to eliminate arousal. No bonk. Watch my bonking video, study our body of work, understand arousal. But the last thing I want you doing is when you're around people and your dog's already aroused, is that the last thing I want anybody to be doing out there is yanking on their dog. Next.
Crixis. Hi, Jeff and Zoe. I think when someone doesn't like you and then ends up liking you is the ultimate compliment. Says a lot about your character.
Yeah, yes and no. But yeah, you didn't like me.
Yeah. Well, I didn't know much either.
It's okay. I didn't take it personally. Thank you for the compliment. I just think that people need to stop passing judgment before they have all the information. But also, I think people have to stop disliking. You know, and hate. I mean, geez. Don't even hate. We shouldn't hate anybody. Dislike? I get it, but all that stuff's unhealthy. You know, next.
Sonia, hi. I brought a prong collar and it came in last week. If I take a link off, it's too tight, but if I add one, it's too loose. Also, love your videos.
If you've got a dog with a lot of fur, make it a little bit loose. Also, what you can do is if it's the prong collar with that center plate, you can take the center plate out, redo the prong so they all face the same way, and that'll save you half a link. Next.
Jamie, how do you feel about the pet convincer? Is it a great tool in your opinion?
We carry them, but we don't use them because we bonk. But it's good for puppies to stop them from whining. It's good for some reactivity. It's good for some crate nonsense. We carry them on our website. It's funny, we sell a ton of them, but we don't even use them in our training center anymore. Next.
Okay, thanks, Jeff. I was just thinking to go do what I know to do and not worry about getting some stupid certificate. Appreciate the knowledge and help as always.
Yeah, I mean, guys. I'm not going to call it a stupid certificate. I'm just saying nothing replaces hands-on experience. There's a lot of people out there that can write really well. They can argue online really well. They can like quote all kinds of stuff. Hand them a leash, they can't even walk the dog. Show me what you can do. Don't tell me, show me. Sorry, that's what it is. That's what it is. Next.
Bitless equestrian, I just got a crate for my one-year-old Great Pyrenees. I put him in last night and he cried all night. Should I put him in an e-collar on?
Yes.
And whenever he cries, I correct?
Yep, you sure do. And for all the people out there that will say that will create a negative association with the dog, the crate, that's an outright blatant lie. We've never seen it happen. We do it all the time. All you're doing is teaching that dog to shut up. And it's like, whoa, so who's that, Sonia or Bill is a question? You should make the crate more inviting. What the hell does that mean? L.L. Bean embroidered bed, bottled water, snacks, stuffed toys, chew bones. The dog's still going to whine. Exercise the dog more. Fine, exercise the dog more. Dog's still going to whine. It's separate. Whine, shut up. Dog stops whining. Problem solved. Next.
Big guns. Dog likes to scratch at e-collar when I'm giving such a pying command. Usually will stop and scratch instead of following command. How do I fix this?
What you can do is have the leash on the dog still and then correct the dog out of that. Next.
Kari,
slow your questions down.
Can you correct a dog that has shut down to the point of dropping down and refusing to move? Too late. A cat attacked my dog at her potty spot and now she refuses to
Jeez.
Go there or potty there. She shuts down now if I say go potty.
Well, she doesn't shut down. She's just like, fuck that. Think about it. That's how powerful a punisher is. Your dog was punished for going to the bathroom in a certain spot. And now it avoids it. So, you know, and a lot of people might be like, oh, well, make it a happy place. Like your dog's like, so it ain't no happy place anymore. Nobody wants to get attacked by pussy. All right. So this is the thing. What I want you to do is this. You can find another potty spot. Or, if you brought your dog to that potty spot, it still might not go to the bathroom. It still might not be nervous. So, what I would that's going to be a hard one. You know what? If my dog got attacked at a potty spot, I would have it on a leash, bring it to the potty spot. It knows go potty on command. But if it refuses to, now what do? The dog's got to go to the bathroom, right? The dog has to go to the bathroom. So, that's a rough one. I would be like, I mean, counter conditioning takes time. Dog has to pee. Dog has to poo. Do I pick up another potty spot? If anything, I would at least start by getting that dog to walk into that potty spot and walk out. Start with that. Next.
Cheyenne and Zeke, good evening, guys. Hey, Zoe. Hey.
Good. That was a short one.
Smith is 2 weeks old, enough for a dog to learn off-leash recall and e-collar.
2 weeks or 2 months?
No. 2 weeks.
2 weeks? Dog that can't learn. Shit. If it's 2 months, no. 2 years? Rephrase that question. I can't answer that question because if you have a two-week-old dog, it should, like, it doesn't know anything. You shouldn't even own it. Next.
Danielle, I have a fearful dog. I've been doing tons of exposure. E-collar works like a dream and prong.
Next.
Sonia, also I watched your video on separation anxiety and give my dog ample time alone, but once I spend time with her, it goes right back to the annoying barking, whining, and etc. whatever I leave.
So bark collar on your dog. That's the barking in the crate, right?
Whining.
That's a hard one sometimes. Sometimes if you get the super sensitive ones, like from eCower Technology, we have them on our website. Some whining it picks up. Next.
Danielle, do you suggest anything else to get her out of the fear during the exposure?
The potty one?
No, she's just a
fearful dog. Massive amounts of structure. Push the dog past its threshold. A lot of people would be like, keep the dog under the threshold. No. It's called flooding with guidance. You can push the, if you know what you're doing, which a lot of people don't, which is fine. That's not your fault. But I would start with basic commands. Hold the dog accountable for basic commands. All right. And then start doing duration work around these commands with environmentals coming in. Next.
8-month-old dog has high food drive. She becomes obsessive when she hears the food. Can I reduce her food drive? We've been working on out.
Reduce her food drive? Yeah, I mean, you want to utilize food drive for... there's no reason to reduce the dog's food drive. Just use it to train stuff and then take away food. Next.
Kicking a dead cat. I have a 4-month-old Walker Coonhound. He kept attacking my older dog. He's great with people, kids, and even other dogs. One bonk and he was off and calm. No other way would he come off.
Yeah, bonking is great. Next.
Fantastic. Whenever I leave my dog home alone, he self-mutilates by biting his paw. I have outruled allergies, dog food, etc., and have established separation anxiety. What should I do? He gets lots of exercise.
So, yeah, more people will say, oh, make sure he gets a lot of exercise. So that's a hard one if you're not there. What we do with dogs like that is if we see them self-mutilating, believe it or not, we would correct them on the remote. Some people will put bitter apple on the dog's arms, but guess what though? Some dogs don't care about any of that stuff. So what we see a lot of times that with dogs that self-mutilate, you got to put a video camera on them. You have to correct the self-mutilation, but also when I use the phrase, what's the rest of the day look like? What's the rest of the day look like? How much structure's in the rest of the day? What else are you doing? Are you only being casual with everything and then putting the dog in the crate? We find that a lot of stuff goes away when you have more structure and hold the dog accountable. But on that, you might have to sit there with a nanny cam, wait for the dog to start self-mutilating, correct it. Next.
Gloria, hello, I'm looking into purchasing another prong collar for my dog. I previously purchased the classic Herm Springer collars, but I'm curious about their buckle/click lock prong collar. Have you heard anything about them or tried them out?
Depends what size. Some you lose a couple of links. Quick release is good for people with dexterity issues. The buckle, sometimes you lose a little bit of links and you don't get the pop. You don't get the pop. But there's a couple of different variations of those. Get one and try. Next.
Josepha. Hi, Jeff.
Hey, Josepha.
Enlightened canine perspective, working with the first dog that is not fazed by the e-collar. She has super short fur, so contact is not an issue. 100 does nothing, but she makes her neck twitch. This is a boss.
Okay, so this is the thing. Training. Start with your... Remember, you might be actually just freaking the dog out. So what I want you to do is start with all your basic obedience on leash. Leash and food. Layer the remote. Remote and food. And then just keep that program going. Keep that program going. Next.
Donna Dutchy, working with Shutzun trainer with multiple world titles.
Excellent. Good. Now, one of the things that I'm going to disagree with on your Shutzun trainer, as well as like a lot of trainers, but is they might not want you to calm your dog down. So we want your dog to have, I want your dog to have work mode and home mode. I don't do work mode. So I own working dogs, but I sort of work them, but I do family pet stuff. So the family pet part is like, you want your dog to do a downstay in place for hours. Your current trainer might say, don't do that, it'll ruin the drive. It doesn't. The last thing you want is a Dutchie that you can't turn off. Next.
Karen, GSD lover, good evening, Jeff and Zoe. My dog doesn't really react to leash pops, has thick fur and thick head, LOL. Is this unusual or am I doing it incorrectly? My first dog responded perfectly to leash pops, thanks.
Yep, and this is a different dog. So, not that every dog has to be trained differently, but after 7,000 plus dogs, there are some variables in there. your leash pop might not be what we would do for a leash pop. You might be underwhelming the dog. Remember, prong collar, as barbaric as it looks, cannot hurt dogs. Have they? So I guess I shouldn't say cannot. I'm sure a dog has been hurt. We're not seeing it. I've never seen it since I've been dog training for 15 years. I've never seen a dog that has been training in our facility hurt with a prong collar. Haven't seen it. Now, that doesn't mean it doesn't happen, but, like, you'd think I would see it at some point. Next.
Lucas, dog starts barking while being left outside. Feed her outside. Use Kong play lots.
Doesn't matter. No. Correct the dog. No, correct. Use a remote collar. So all these dogs with all this behavior, if your trainer's, okay, dogs do need exercise. I'm not going to discount that. But more exercise does not make better behavior. It just doesn't. That's a lie. If you want to stop barking outside, you use a bark collar or remote collar, and you make it uncomfortable to bark. Next.
Norm continued to make progress with my DA pit lab mix. Sometimes she just doesn't listen. How much of that is behavior versus personality?
Either way, it doesn't make a difference. You need a dog that listens, so you need to find a motivator. So if you're training something brand new in obedience, your motivator is probably going to either be most likely food. And if you're trying to stop something, or if the dog is a selective listener, you're going to use a punisher. Next.
Josepha, hi, Jeff and Zoe. Love your shirt, Jeff. By the way, we are taking our dog off of Prozac.
Huh. Good. I get your dog off Prozac, too. Sounds good. Next.
Brian, hey, Jeff. My dog, who is a dog aggressive, doesn't seem to even care about corrections. I give him with the prong collar. As soon as he sees other dogs, people just handbags that look like leashes, etc. He barks, lunges. Even when I step in and correct the behavior right before it happens, I have gotten him settled down using it with a few dogs, and it turns out he is just really afraid of them.
Okay. Well, how do we know he's afraid of them? That's your interpretation. He might be, but how do you know that? Just because he barks at another dog doesn't mean fear. It doesn't mean he's afraid. So, again, once the dog is in drive, once the dog has already gone up the ladder of drive, a lot of your nonsense can escalate the dog. That's why you want to get the dog at the very, very beginning. One of the things we demonstrate at our seminars is how to recognize that and how to stop that immediately. Immediately. So your dog even looks at a dog right now, I would switch to a remote collar. There'd be a consequence. Why? Because you know if you don't address it, where that can go. Next.
Bitless equestrian, how many hours do you think I should have my dog in a crate a day?
Well, what's your lifestyle? I don't know. I don't know what your lifestyle is. Next.
Brian, I'm not sure what to do because every time I see a new dog, it's like back to square one and he completely forgets about the corrections I've given him from the past. Please help.
So right here on this show, it's going to be hard to do. I'd recommend doing a Skype. All I can do is tell you is remote collar training is going to dramatically help. Addressing with a punisher the first sign that your dog is starting to look at another dog, that dramatically helps. But then also being proactive by teaching your dog how to properly walk. So you're proactive by teaching your dog how to properly walk. And then you're going to be reactive by applying a punisher at the first sign that your dog is even looking. But again, guys, just cranking on the dog doesn't fix the problem. Next.
Julie, I did have a huge success with my girl. She is a 4-year-old pit that had no socialization or training before our family. Had a friend come over and we crated her. She protested, barked a few times, then she laid down in her crate and just chilled.
Awesome. Good job. And just make it quicker. You can correct that barking. Next.
Shaquila. Hey, Jeff, you have no idea how much I have learned from you. Thank you for all you do, and thank you for giving us free advice. I tell all my friends about you.
Shaquila, thank you. Wow, I'm flattered. Thank you so much for the kind words. Next.
G, with proper training, can a dog reactive towards strangers and dogs be able to socialize with dogs?
Yeah, absolutely. But I don't know your skill set, and I don't know the other dogs. So there's a lot of variables out there, guys, a lot of variables. Like, there's dogs that, like, I wouldn't want my dogs around. No matter how well-behaved they are. I wouldn't want your dogs around no matter how well-behaved they are. So there's a lot of variables. Next. But yes, we do it all the time. Next.
Bitless equestrian. Yeah, for sure. No more public petting. I got an a collar that has two huge do not pet patches on it. I think those will be helpful, but I know people and still be at
right. So I'm not against those, but I'd rather you open up your mouth next. But let me just tell you something really funny, guys. Nobody asked me to pet my dogs. I usually walk with two German Shepherds and a Malinois. Nobody asked me. And they don't look mean. They're friendly. And they are friendly dogs. Nobody has ever given me a hard time about training equipment in public. Online, everybody's a bully. Everybody's a bully. But in public, not one person has ever come up to me and said anything about training equipment. Why? Guys, it's a state of mind of you. If you truly, truly, truly don't give a shit what other people say or other people think, I'm telling you, that cuts out 95% of people that would do it. You don't have to walk around looking mean. But if you truly, truly, truly believe, and how do you know when you don't? When you try to explain stuff to people. Oh, no, 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 it doesn't hurt the dog. It's like, you don't believe it then. And you care. So don't give a shit what other people think. Truly believe that what you're doing is proper. And you'd be surprised, and walk like you know it. Like you feel it. It's inside of you. You'd be surprised who leaves you alone. You'd be surprised who leaves you alone. So when I used to, back when I was in the adult industry, we ran a fetish party. Every Wednesday night, we actually started the party. We actually created a market. We did a fetish party every Wednesday night. And since I put it on, it's actually where I met my wife, Linda, actually. The club had the doorman, George. He had the doorman, and then I was there to collect the money, because the way it worked is I keep the door, the bar gets the alcohol. So they had a bunch of bouncers there. George was the quiet one. George was the quiet one. By the way, George, I love you. If you ever see this, I'd love to see what you're up to. He would just go up to people and he would just really, really go up to them and say, we're not going to have a problem tonight. You're going to just get your stuff and you're going to leave right now. And the people were just like, okay. And they left. And there was other people at the club that were like more physical and more and louder. And it's funny because George was with me the night that we got shot at. Did you ever hear that story? Did I ever share that story?
No.
Yeah. Yeah. We got shot at. Yeah.
Why?
So the club that we ran, the fetish night was, we had a dress code. Mm-hmm. You had to wear something like some, you know, whether it's, you know, leather, latex, vinyl, lingerie. I get all emotional thinking about this. Hold on. Lingerie, cross-dress, at a minimum, all black. But the Hells, we had to deal with the Hells Angels. Hells Angels can come in and do, they can come in their gear. They can wear their colors into this club. So that was never a problem. And one time, and this was, and the Hell, by the way, there was only like one or two Hells Angels that went there, but it's not like it was not a biker club. But some other biker guys came there one night and we said to them, sorry, you can't come in. Because you weren't dressed. You know, they were wearing their colors and they couldn't do it. The guy was drunk. So he walks away from the club. He's 10 feet away. He turns around, pulls out a gun from his waistband. George and I are standing right outside the club. And points it at us and fucking starts firing off rounds.
Oh my God. Nope.
And we, at the club, there's a little alcove. You know, there's the alcove that you can go into before the door. And we just backed up into the door. And, like, car windows were smashing. Nobody was shot.
God.
And then he took off and the police caught him. Yeah. And I'm sure we told our Hells Angels buddies, like, by the way, you might want to check in on this other guy. So, yeah. So I'm sure there's more consequences besides the police. Next.
$5 top chat. Becky, 5-month-old Aussie tries to get my 2 Bengal cats to play with him. They're just not having it. Best way to get him to stop pouncing on them.
Bonker. So look up bonker. No bonk. Next.
Hey Jeff and Zoe, hope you are both having a great day. Thank you all for your content.
You having a great day?
Yes.
Me
I'm
too.
Having a good day.
Yeah. I think every day is a good day.
Yeah. I got to open today.
Now that you're single.
I've never had a boyfriend.
Oh, bullshit.
I never had a boyfriend.
Where's Ben? Ben just came in here. Ben, what's his name?
No.
He's got like,
even know his name.
He's got three names. You dump that guy like a fucking hot potato, Zoe.
That's how I roll.
That's right.
That's how I do
it. I'm proud of you. You're only 18 years old and you were like, you know what? You're not, it's not that you're not trying, what words did you use? It's not that you're not trying to, you're not making any effort.
Yeah.
Okay? You're not making any effort. Mm-hmm. We're done. Good for you.
Thank you.
Good for you. I'm proud of you.
Shanika. Hi, Jeff. My Corso started pulling on leash a lot today once she realized her, I got bumped.
I know that happens.
Nope, down here. Whoa. Realized her prong was off. She did well all week, but not today. Would I take her a step back, go back to the prong, or put an e-collar on her?
So, who's that, Shaniqua?
Yeah.
Shaniqua, why take off the prong? Why? Why take it off? That's not... Make your life easier. Use the prong. Next.
LC, what size prong for bull mastiff, 14 months old, 29-inch neck, need additional collar as backup?
3 millimeter. 3 millimeter. Next.
Edgar. Hello, guys. Just watched your previous vids. Love that guy who trained his dog to cross the bridge, and he is teaching you how to train your dog.
Hmm? What? Who is that?
Edgar's.
Edgar's? What are you talking about, Edgar's? Watch your previous vids. Love that guy who trained. Oh, we talk about it. We talked about the guy that tried to cross the bridge. Yeah, that was a funny one, Edgar's. I know. He took him 7 months. It was a piece of hate mail that I get. I get a lot of bashing. He's like, that's really mean, da-da-da-da-da. You don't want to stress dogs out. He goes, I got my dog to cross a bridge, and it only took 7 months. And you're bragging about that?
Mary, getting a new golden puppy in a few weeks. Should I use his daily food or training? Will it create high food drive?
Use it both. Use his daily food. You want to utilize that food drive. Next.
Nick, when bringing new dog in home, what is the first thing I should teach? Down, sit, place, etc.
Kenneling up. Next.
Dog whines while in place. Go to apply correction. Leash pop. Dog growls before correction. Ooh. After correction, dog has aggressive bark. What would Jeff do?
That's all objection bullshit. So I'd actually bonk the dog. No bonk. But I would look into getting a remote collar because then you can just do, you can actually correct whining from up to half a mile away, technically. Next.
Amy, hi, love the no bullshit. If my dog is crated while I'm at work, is it bad for him to sleep in bed with me?
Oh, what's the behavior? So does your dog have any resource guarding, leash reactivity, separation anxiety, dog aggression, human aggression? So this is the way I look at it. If love and affection is above structure, guidance, leadership, and consequences, you're going to lose. Just remember that. So that's going to be on you. I don't know enough about your dog. Next.
Tanya Tate, hi from Canada.
Hey, Canada. Love you, Canada.
Nick. Planning to go to Fargo in September for your seminar. Is there anything I can do to better prepare to get the most out of the session?
Yeah, buy a ticket. So get a ticket to Fargo. Most of my seminars, working spots sell out. Better prepare. If you want to start down your journey, you can now, but you don't have to. People bring me the worst behaved dogs in the world. They do fine. They'll do fine. Next.
Justin posted question twice. Sorry.
Justin.
The elevated squirrel. Any easy scent related game ideas for the backyard?
You can hide Kongs. Do search games. You can probably, there's probably some, who's that, Justin?
No, the elevated squirrel.
Elevated squirrel. There's probably some really cool videos on there on like basic odor games, basic scent games. Next.
Dino, just curious, what's harder to solve in your opinion, kid or dog aggression? I feel like I've had better results with my dog and son than I have with dog and approaching dogs. I'm sure it's skill set.
It's skill set, and there's also dog variable too. Next.
Julie, a pet convincer with a bonker at times way got our dog from going over to our back fence and initiating aggressive barking. Thank you.
You're welcome. That's dangerous, having a dog jump a fence. Next.
Keaton, can you talk about proper ways to hold the leash and scratch the surface of leash handling skills?
I don't have a... No, here we go. No, fuck that. I'll make a video. We'll make a video this week. Next.
L. Doyle, haha, my cats are neutered. We had two adult cats, but just got that kitten last week. Avoidance is...
Oh, I see. You got a kitten. Yes.
Avoidance as in use the e-collar and give correction when she is looking at the cat.
Yes. Next.
Jared, does the pet convincer have no effect on some dogs? Do some dogs even enjoy it? When I was first training my dog, I used it and it had zero effect. I then switched to a prong collar and it has no reactivity.
So, yeah, some dogs don't give a shit about a lot of stuff. Next.
Angelica, got my mini educator today. Dog always barks and crate. I said no and punish. He's now nice and quiet.
What do you know? Who's that, Angelica?
Yes.
So look at Angelica. Guys, I'm telling you, no negative association with the crate. It's called consequences. Dog barks, something uncomfortable happens. Oh, maybe I should stop barking. Next.
Edgar, crate question. Yes, Jeff, I thought that you have to crate Wonderland in crate, but I was wrong. My Mally sleeps in crate all night now without any issues. Thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah, all my dogs, all of our, well, your dog's not here.
My dog sleeps in a crate, though.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I think almost every trainer here, whose dog doesn't sleep in a crate?
Ben.
What's his dog do? Sleep in bed with him?
Yeah. No, actually on her bed. She has her own bed.
Yeah. Well, Ben can do whatever he wants to do. It all depends on the behavior. But most of us sleep. That's Ben. He's one out of... I'm sure some other staff does not have their dog sleep in crates. I wonder if Jess does. I can see Jess not.
I don't know.
We'll ask Jess tomorrow. Next.
Elsie, how to walk Mastiff on Prong.
Dog training. Watch my video. Well, I've got a good video. I've got a good video on how to fit the prong, how to introduce the prong, and then how to start the walk. Next.
Tanya Tate, any ideas how to create leadership role while structure walk? Example, if you live in a wheelchair.
So for wheelchair folks, I want to highly suggest you also remote collar train your dog. It's going to actually give you a lot more freedom and control over your dog. This is it. Heel is heel is heel. Whether you're in your wheelchair or a scooter or on a bicycle or walking or running, heel is heel. There's a lot of things you can do to create leadership with your dog. Holding your dog accountable to commands. But so I'm not quite sure about your. So obviously you've got some lower body issues. I'm not sure how the dexterity in your hands are. But even then, you can adapt the remote collar to even limited function in your hands as well. But what's going to happen is the remote collar is going to be really, really great, because once you get your dog up to no, it's as easy as saying no and pushing a button. But that takes training to do. But you can do it all on your own. Next.
Three dogs. Dog reacts by barking at dog he sees on walks. I'm using an e-collar to correct when he starts to escalate. Perhaps I'm underwhelming him. He reacts to the stim with a yipe, but will continue barking. It appears correction increases reactivity.
Because your timing probably could be off. And there are some other variables as well, but it could be the timing. So if your dog's already aroused, yes, the dog feels something uncomfortable, but then keeps going. What I would do is I would start looking for signs earlier in the sequence. Next.
Okay, if my dog flops down halfway on place or rolls over to sleep and comes off place, do I correct or let it go? He stays in place.
Well, if he rolls over and sleeps, leave him alone. Next.
Hey, it's Christy. Jeff, it's been ages since I've caught you live. I have a 9-week-old Dobie who I love dearly but is holy terror.
Okay.
Time to check out your puppy videos.
Christy. Christy, Christy, Christy. How the fuck could you love a 9-week-old puppy dearly? Come on. What, have you owned the dog for a week? Love the dog dearly? guys, let's stop throwing out that fucking love word. Because if you told you love me, I'd be like, I want it to have some meaning to it. So, because what you're going to do is you're going to be pissed off at that fucking dog because it's a puppy. Puppies are hard. Puppies are frustrating. So, massive amounts of food training, tons of structure, tons of routine. But Ma was amazed by the love comment. Krista, you're not a bad person. I love you. So, this is the thing. And I love you differently than I love my kids. And I love my spouse. And I love people that I truly care about. But it's still, I have a very deep emotional feeling for my fans. Absolutely. But 9-week-old puppy. Come on. It's a pain in the ass. Next.
Kari, for the comment about not being fazed by level 100, I had a cheap e-collar my dog ignored 100 with, a tight fit, but a more expensive collar. She responds to 10. Spend more for better quality.
Always spend more. Next.
Yep. Oh, got bumped. So sorry. I can't find it. Oh, here we go.
Next.
Lynn, I have used to keep under threshold for 22 months and hasn't worked. Had a prong collar for 2 weeks. Not yet met any other dogs as we getting used to it before.
Slow down your fucking questions, Zoe. Jesus Christ.
That's how I read.
Okay, good. Well, learn how to slow them down and put damn pauses in between the damn words.
Okay, as we getting used to it before meet any. I thought you typed it. Wish I have seen you earlier. That wasn't me. That wasn't all me, okay?
Next. Good. Congratulations. Next.
Lynette, my 2-year-old.
You're trying to rush through the questions.
I'm not.
Yes, you are.
I'm not.
Zoe, you're trying to rush through the questions.
I'll slow down. Okay.
It's like, Jeff, I'm trying to get away from you as quick as possible tonight. You got 30 minutes left in the fucking show. Speeding up the questions ain't going to get you out of this.
I'm not trying to speed up the questions.
Well, slow it down.
I'm slowing down. Okay, I'll slow down. Lynette, 2-year-old dog adopted a year ago. My other dog's anxiety has way increased, and if new dog whines or walks by, older pup leaves the room with head down. New dog trained and not aggressive. What the hell?
Your other dog is saying, fuck this shit, I'm out of here. That's what your dog is saying. So, what do you do? What do you do? And this was really funny about that interaction we just had. Someone is going to literally post on the video about, like, how could you treat that girl, they'll say girl, so poorly, you asshole. It's like, don't you get the fucking goddamn show? It's like, guys, stop taking life so seriously. But I get those all the time. People will comment, it's like, I can't believe the way you treat, like, they'll talk about Joelle or my wife. They'll be like, about Linda, who's not on the show anymore. She's like, I can't believe you talked to your wife like that. I'm like, first of all, you didn't see her elbow go into my ribs really hard. And second of all, it's an entertainment show. I can't talk to Zoe like this at all during the day or at night off the show. You become sort of like a non-employee, technically.
Yeah, I get
but,
it.
Like, I can't. I know you get it. It's like people, because people have made comments like, "It must be so much fun to work." Like, you think I can interact like this?
It's way more serious during the day.
It's way more serious. It has to be serious. We work with serious dogs, and it's a serious workplace. And we actually have freaking laws that you have to be careful what you say around another person. So, what's the question?
Just that her older dog walks
away. Oh, walks away. So your dog literally is just uncomfortable about the other dog. Next.
Jared, I have a 3-year-old Basset cattle dog mix. He does well on prong collar, but I want to introduce an e-collar. Can I go straight into correction, or do I need
No.
Marker first?
Yes. Please do not go right into correction. Other than like counter surfing, getting in the trash can, getting in the litter box, eating poop. Please do not correct your dog on a remote collar for lack of obedience until you have trained your dog on the remote collar. Thanks.
Jesse, aside from high-level corrections, is there a rule of thumb for when to use a bonker instead of an e-collar? Wouldn't an e-collar work for anything? You'd use a bonker?
No, absolutely not. A bonker is one of the best ways to eliminate arousal. One of the best ways. I've had dogs that have blown through a double boss, hard working dogs. Bonker, boom, all set. You're like, what? How could that be possible? It just is. Next.
Do you have experience with introducing a dog to a prosthetic born without back for 1/4 of leg, 8-month-old?
No, but, she's in Dallas, Texas. Oh, shoot. Amy is her first name. Amy Feltz, F-E-L-T-S. She has got, she documented her whole journey with prosthetics. Next.
Pam, excited about Las Vegas, getting closer, can't wait. Dog still goes whiny and nuts on walks with fence runners. Hope we can fix it. By the way, we decided to stay at the Oasis RV Park in Vegas.
Nice. Vegas is going to be great. Vegas, baby. Next.
Brian, this is a three-parter. Do you want me to?
Brian? Yep, go ahead.
Brian, he is great walking using prong collar corrections. Once calm near other dogs, he tries to avoid slash hide behind me, so that it's why I think he's afraid. The problem is there is a lot of dogs around me where I live, so we generally turn the corner or open the elevator door and see another dog suddenly, so it's near impossible to step in and correct before he sees other dogs.
Got it. So, I'm sorry, I didn't let you finish.
Even if I step in before, if the dog is at a distance and give him corrections, he still just escalates and gets over threshold.
Right. So, there's always going to be those what-ifs. You're on a journey. Brian, you're on a journey. The reason why the dog is avoiding is because you're training the dog that if it reacts, there's going to be a consequence. So, the dog then moves away from the environmental. But there's always those what ifs. And that's why we keep training. Next.
Can I train dog to not do jump slash stay off furniture except when I invite her to do otherwise? Or would that be confusing and counterproductive?
One more time, sorry.
Can I train dog to not jump slash stay off of furniture except when I invite her to do otherwise?
Yes, absolutely. Next.
Nick, my job requires me to live where I work at a college. I find that I am constantly addressed for using prong or e-collar to correct my dogs. Is there a way for me to do it that won't shock others? It's crazy.
College campuses in 2019? Good luck. Put a bandana on your dog. Next.
Shanika, I totally agree. I was too soft spoken before. Guy stopped me in the middle of crossing the street at a busy intersection to tell me that my prong collar is cruel. I nodded my head, said it's my dog's, she's in training. I'm not harming her, just giving her correction. Walked away and he fucked off.
But that was even too much. That was too much of a conversation. You don't speak English. Keep walking. Next.
Lucas, I own 3 dogs. 2 of them are terrible on walks. Going through the process of training them, should it be one-on-one or multiple prongs and e-collars?
Huh? Say that one more time.
I own 3 dogs. 2 of them are terrible on walks. Going through the process
of
training
them. Oh, got it. Okay, yeah, train them one-on-one first. Train each dog by itself and then put them together. Next.
El Doyle, I was at the Hellraiser's ball tattooing when I was shot at 2 when the pagans and the angels pagans and the angels got into a turf war. My wife was pregnant and we went into preterm labor while we were stuck
Fuck.
Jesus.
In Waco, there was a big in that parking lot in Waco. Remember we hear about that? That was maybe 3 or 4 years ago. It was like a chicken wing place or a Mexican restaurant. It's a family restaurant. There's a huge shooting there. Next.
Marianne, when I first started following you, your comments about George Jefferson was what stuck in my mind the most. After that, I would channel my best George Jefferson and our walks began to change.
It's true. Next.
Amy, thanks.
You're welcome.
Melanie, dog sleeps in bed. He is reactive at least. If I kick him out of bed, will it help? Will he hate me?
Okay, first of all, your dog won't hate you. You're humanizing the dog. Put your dog into a crate. You'll be fine. Your dog won't hate you, though. Next.
Wesley, I'm a recovering positive only cult member. Thank you for teaching me corrections are not inhumane. I have a much better trained dog now.
Guys, anybody that thinks that they can fix dogs without a correction or a punishment, it's a dream world. You're living in an absolute dream world. Next.
Monica. Hi, Zoe. How did you get into dog training and working for Jeff? I had a terrible dog. And
you already shared that. Just say you'll watch the replay. You're next.
Are your seminars structured or are topics covered based on attendees' questions?
Yeah, they're, I speak for me. Well, I speak a lot, but I don't lecture. In other words, I work dogs. So you bring me a dog, we work the dog. Next.
Hey guys, Jeff, let me know if you got my latest email. Love you.
Who said that?
I can't read that. It's in Spanish.
Raquel. I did, Raquel. I'll get back to you maybe tonight or tomorrow.
Uh-oh.
Next. She's in Brazil.
Nick, how long to keep bark collar on before you take it off? I had on for 2 weeks at times. I knew she would bark, but then when I thought it was corrected, I took it off and she just barked all day.
Yeah, leave it on all the time. Next. Not all the time. Go to work, put the bark collar on, you're done. Just make it standard operating equipment. Next.
Brittany, I have been working on doorbell reactivity and bonked my dogs for barking. Only took one bonk and no more barking. You can teach an old dog something new.
Of course you can. As long as the dog is breathing, you can teach it. If it's not breathing, it knows a good downstay. Next.
Shanika, I also want to tell you thank you so much for you have so much. Thank you so much for... You have literally changed our daily life with her behavior and had drastically changed your methods. Are so effective. Look forward to more advice and learning from you.
Thank you, Shaniqua.
Tanya, thank you. Did not realize the delay.
Yeah, there's a delay in this.
Odd. Are you going to have a seminar in California?
In Petaluma, California. I've got one in November or December, but Vegas is going to be for all my Southern California folks. Next.
Barney, I can't get Herm Springer prong collar delivered to Australia. Is it okay to use the Asian copy collars?
Yeah, if you want to, but you can get them. Give there's a guy down in Sydney that sells them. Steve is his name. Canine something. Shoot, I don't remember. Next.
Melanie, dog freaks out at runners and bikers. They come out of the blue. I try to correct and obviously too late as he redirects on me. What do I do? I use prong collar.
So, muzzle him up, number one, and role play the hell out of it. Next. So search for runners and bikers. Search for them. Go hunting for them. Next.
Odd P says thanks.
You're welcome.
Hey, it's Christy. Jeff, I should have thought about my choice of word, love, for my 9-week-old Dobie. You have told me about using the L word before. My bad. I love you, too. And yes, he is a pain in my ass.
Christy, I'm not joking with you, but I'm joking with you. Next.
Ma Baker, hey, guys. My three dogs can behave one, but when they are all together on walks, they sometimes don't know anything. I've learned them, and they go... bananas. Why is that? What do I? I'm not reading. It's how it's on here. Okay.
Okay. Wait. Can you say? How about this?
I'm like thinking. I'm trying to think of what they're saying. And
right.
I'm,
and then and, then, and then put it into the words. So this is the thing. So she's new. I've got to coach her as we go.
Mm-hmm.
You know what probably people are saying.
Yes.
Correct.
But when I'm reading, I just read.
Right. So read and then be like, okay, that doesn't make sense. What are they probably trying to say?
Okay.
So in other words. Three dogs do great on their own, put them together, and they're assholes. Right.
Yes.
So, because there's some skill set there. So you pick the biggest asshole, you keep that next to you, that's the one that you straighten out first, and the other two will follow. Next.
Raquel says, laughing emojis, the show is the funniest time of the day. I love it.
Thank you, Raquel. Oops. I love you too, honey. She wants me to be a guest on her podcast.
You should.
In Brazil. I'm not the guest. I don't do guest spots.
You don't do guest spots?
No, I don't.
Nope. No,
but Raquel, I will.
Edgar's. Yeah, Jeff, be nice. LOL. Love it.
Yep.
Jeff, thanks for sharing your wisdom. Please don't use the Lord's name in vain.
Who said that?
Emphiament.
Okay. M, stop saying that. I'm sorry. I swear. Don't take it personally. It comes out. People always comment about that. It's, I'm not a religious person, and I don't mean any disrespect, but it's, my show is going to sound like my show is going to sound. If it bothers you that much, you might have to make a choice to not listen to me. Unfortunately, I'm usually not aware of it. It just comes out. Every once in a while, someone will say that, and I will be, I usually will just comment back saying, you know, they'll put a comment. They won't say it live. They'll put a comment and I'll be like, don't listen to the show. But it just comes out. It comes out. I don't look at it. I'm not looking at it the same way you are looking at it. And I don't mean any disrespect at all to what your beliefs are. Next.
Okay, what is a reasonable price to charge for your first fee in home board and train, 3 weeks?
I have no idea what your skill set is, the results that you get, or anything. I do business consults. I would need way more information. Next.
Norm, Jeff, can you explain what typically happens in a Skype session and what they are most useful for, please?
So, I'll tell you what. It's way more serious than this. I don't swear. I don't use the Lord's name in vain. It's you set the itinerary. What you do is when you sign up for a Skype, you email Jessica. On the Skype form, you write down what you want to talk about. You can email us videos that you want me to review. And then we take it from there. We just take it from there. And it's obviously just lots of one-on-one guidance. Next.
Cheyenne and Zeke, update on grandmother's poodle. He doesn't jump on grandma anymore, and he doesn't dash out open doors. He doesn't beg anymore either. He's doing great.
Wow. Look at that. Grandma. Grandma's poodle. I think you're training grandma's poodle. Wait, you live with grandma's poodle, I think. You just, something like that, if I remember. Next.
Lynn, who is George Jefferson? I'm from the UK, so don't know.
George, look it up. Look up The Jeffersons. It's a sitcom that was in the 70s/80s. Look up The Jeffersons. Next.
Odd P, I have a dog that starts screaming when he sees other dogs and bites the leash. He whines nonstop on walks looking for other dogs. He won't heal and pulls on the prong. Should I try an e-collar?
You could, but I would also, at the very beginning of the walk, start out pretty firmly. I know who Benny Hill is, and I'm in the United States. Why don't you know who George Jefferson is? Next.
Jared, literally cracking up in the office from that knows a good downstate joke.
Sorry. Next.
Sue Palmer, hi Jeff. When starting prong training, should the collar stay on all day even while not training?
No. Next.
Raquel says, Jeff, you know you will be the star in my show, not just a guest. You know that.
No, I don't know that at all. I don't know that at all. Next.
That's the last one.
The last one?
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Yeah, surprisingly.
You know, I just got an email that's a text that says, let me read this right. Martin Dealey. Martin Dealey died. Oh. Martin Dealey was a dog trainer that's been around forever. He was the president numerous times of the IACP. And I guess he died this morning at 73. Oh, that's so terrible. That's so terrible.
Oh, we got one.
Oh, shit. Oh, my gosh. I'm so sorry. Because he left his wife, I think. I think he's got kids. That's so terrible. Next.
Kari, my dog will be, I don't know what that word is, walk into her potty spot with a prong collar only and still refuses to potty, but we are making progress. Thank you. The cat is long gone, but she still thinks it's still.
I know. That's the power. That's the power of a punisher. Your dog was punished by the cat, and now it's avoiding the whole area. So imagine if you actually wanted your dog to stay out of a certain area. Next.
Lynn Pinchard. Sorry, Jeff. Haha, we'll look it up.
Oh, yeah. George Jefferson. Yeah. Just go on to YouTube. Next.
Okay. Thanks for all your help.
You're welcome.
Jeff, you are doing an amazing job at educating others and offering free advice to all. Seriously, kiddos.
I live for this. Every morning I wake up and I'm like, how can I add more value to the marketplace? That's what I do. I wake up every morning and I literally am like, what can I do today to help more people? Next.
Christine, of course you know Benny Hill, LOL.
Benny Hill, yeah. That's because there's nudity. Next.
Norman Grassfeld, RIP.
Rest in peace.
Yeah.
Tip for Martin. Yep, next.
Jared, what is your favorite food?
Ooh, I'm a foodie. Ah. I love seafood. I love sushi. Can I say sushi? Can I just be as bold? Can I just be as bold and say sushi?
Say sushi.
Could be sushi. Next.
Angela, so sorry for the loss.
Yeah, it's terrible. Next.
My GSD puppy is 18 weeks. Should I still crate her?
God, yeah. Oh, well, depends. I mean, if you want shit, piss, and your house destroyed, don't. Absolutely. 18 weeks old is nothing. You can crate your dog for years. The rest of its life, actually. I mean, I got a 9-year-old dog that's crated. I've crated dogs until they died at 12. Next.
499 Top Chat, holding on. Dog trading some hump day cash.
Nice. Thanks, Ashley. Love you.
If you want to get a dog, want to get a second dog, at what age is okay? My male is 5 and I want a puppy.
5 years old? Yeah, that's fine. 5 months. If it's 5 months, that's not fine. Wait till at least, I mean, ideally a year, not, you know, maybe 18 months. Also depends on your other dog's behavior. Next.
Julie, how is Linda, Jeff? She hurt her foot.
She's going in for an MRI maybe this week. Next.
Did you get Wes a new ball for the pool?
Wes, a new ball for the pool?
Yeah, his was like ripped up on the live yesterday.
No. Wes ain't getting any new balls.
No, he's not.
No.
Edgar's, I like how people tell you off for the punishing your dog, but it's hard to hear them because the dog is barking his head off.
Yeah, I don't give a shit. I don't give a shit about any of that stuff. Next.
Nick, one of my dogs will lick the mouth and tongue of my other dog. Yep. Weird.
No. That's normal. That's how they say hello usually. Next.
Caitlin, 10-month-old puppy. We live on a farm, so she sees lots of people all the time. Has always been overly friendly, if anything. All of a sudden, she's terrified of everyone and runs around frantically.
10-month-old. Your dog could be going through a fear stage. Also, it's going through a different stage in its life. Probably dog has too much freedom. And we see a lot of bad behaviors come out at the 9-month mark. So what I would do is I would take away that just running around the farm unless you really have got that dog under control. Next.
Matthew, Jeff have a deaf dog coming this weekend for a board and train. First deaf dog, any general advice for training a deaf dog? She'll be on e-collar from the get-go.
From the get-go, yeah. So we definitely want to mark eye contact. One of the first things you want to do is eye contact. But remember, you're using a leash too. So you're going to be still, you know, layering the remote collar over all your leash commands. Lots of food. You want to do tons of food drive. But it's that eye contact that you really want the dog to understand. Next. Because then you're going to be giving the dog hand signals. Next.
Hey, it's Christy. He loves Stromboli.
Stromboli? I don't dislike it. I don't know if there's a food out there I don't like. Yeah, well, you're probably a picky eater.
I am.
Yeah, I'm not a picky eater. Now I don't eat a lot of different food. Like, I don't eat dessert anymore. Mm-hmm. I don't eat a lot of sugary stuff. I don't eat a lot of carbs. I don't eat a lot of pasta anymore. I eat tons of vegetables and tons of fruits and then tons of, not tons of grains anymore. And then lots of protein. And my protein is usually in meat. But meanwhile, this morning I had tempeh with scrambled eggs. Do you ever have tempeh?
Nope, don't know what that is.
It's good.
Rachel says, hi.
Hey, Rachel.
Best behaved pups just signed on. Joelle looks like she's having a blast on vacation.
Yeah, I'm so proud of her. I'm so proud and happy for her. Next.
Tokaj, hello both. Are reactive dogs born reactive, or is it something that develops in them?
It develops. Tokaj is the one that you pretty much insulted
his
child.
The daughter. I didn't insult his child.
Yes, you did insult his child. Insulted his child's feelings.
Insulted me, not his child.
Tokaj was actually, like, he actually emailed me and he goes, Jeff, I can't listen to the show anymore.
Stop.
He goes, is Zoe going to be co-hosting? If Zoe's going to be co-hosting, I don't want to listen to the show.
No.
I'm just letting you know. So, next.
Come to Singapore. We take you to the best seafood.
Singapore. I'm actually working on a seminar in Singapore. Next.
Karen, GSD lover, what was the reference to George Jefferson? I missed that one.
So George Jefferson, I'm like, walk like George Jefferson. Like, walk like him. Own the damn street. Next.
Jared, Cersei's great. We have some amazing revolving sushi bars in my area.
You know what? The revolving sushi bar freaks me out a little bit. Like, when was this made? I've gone to the revolving sushi bar. I've eaten at them. Not my thing. not my thing. Tucson, I went to this one sushi place in Tucson. Woof, was that damn good sushi. I like poke bowls too. Sushi bar, I did a sushi bar in the UK. I mean, a sushi rotating one. Mm-hmm. I did one, I was with my kids. Where were we? I think we might have been in a mall in Florida. And there was a sushi bar that was rotating. That's not my gig. Next.
El Doyle, I'm now ordering sushi.
Awesome.
Nick, what about Wright's Farm Restaurant, best place in Rhode Island?
I actually have never been there, but my wife is a Rhode Islander, and she has. Next.
Odd P, thank you.
You're welcome.
Teresa, hey,
Hold on. Did Nick say the best place in Rhode Island?
Yes, best place in Rhode Island.
Nick, are you serious? The best place in Rhode Island is Wright's Farm. Don't give me Wright's Farm. If you're listening to this, this is not a diss to you, but it's like, have you been to Los Andes? Have you been to Rosalina's? Come on. Rosalina's, please. Los Andes, come on. Nick, go to Los Andes. Tell them I sent you. Next.
He's 5 years old, loves other dogs, an excellent service dog, not excited about people. He is an ACD.
Yeah, that makes a good service dog. You don't want service dogs excited about people or dogs. You want them neutral. Next.
Excuse me?
Yep.
Jared.
Did you just burp? Yes, did you just fucking burp on the air?
Yes, I did. I've been burping.
You just burped on the air.
Yes. It's not as bad as it can be. Trust me.
Ben complains, by the way.
No, he does not. He hears it. He does not hear me burp.
He hears you talk on the phone.
He hears
me
talk on
the
phone.
And we won't even go there. We will not even go down that road.
Jared, what's the most exotic meat you have eaten during your travels around the world?
Ooh. Well, I haven't been to Asia yet. So that I'm excited for. That I'm excited for. Oh, I don't know. Nothing too exotic. Like buffalo, but that's not really exotic.
It's good.
Eel, big deal. Alligator. Not too, probably, you know, eel, alligator, buffalo, deer meat. All your standards, you know, pork, beef, fish, lots of different fishes. So, next.
Caitlin, e-collar trained, has strong threshold command, so she knows she can't leave the barn if I'm not in there. She hasn't been released. However, now all of a sudden she bolts around the barn if kids are there.
Yeah, kids are just arousing the dog. Next.
El Doyle, you should try this stuff my wife bought. I think it's called jackfruit. I don't think there's...
Yeah, jackfruit's good.
I don't think there's a single person who can eat this stuff besides my wife.
Oh, no. Jackfruit's great. Tell your wife that I'm a jackfruit fan. Next.
Julie, my favorite seafood is salmon.
Mine too. I love salmon. I'm going to be up in Alaska. I'm looking forward to it. Next.
Lucas, do you train behaviors the e-collar?
With e-collar? Yeah. So the remote collar, you can do a lot with a remote collar. So you can train all your basic obedience. You can train things close. You can train things at a distance. You can help with... leash reactivity, with dog aggression. You can stop behaviors that you don't want. You can also help this dog state of mind get into a rested state. And that's not by shutting down the dog like we keep hearing. Remote collars are fantastic tools. They're really fantastic tools. Next.
Nick, I now live in SD and I miss Wright so fucking much. But don't worry, I'll fly to Rhode Island and try your suggestion.
Oh, okay, you're in San Diego now. San Diego's got some good restaurants. I'm in San Diego maybe once a year. My folks live there. They live right outside La Jolla. Next.
That's it?
Good, because it's almost time to exit the show. All right, guys. Let's see if Melissa gave me a question to ask here. Question for the replay. Okay. For all the people watching the replay, if you're watching the replay, don't comment here. So the replay gets put out in 2 days from now. What's your favorite memory, from any of the Q&A shows? All right. Madly in love with you. And I will see you guys later. Zoe, thank you so much for doing the show this week.
I enjoyed it.
I appreciate it. All right. Take care. Bye, everybody.